morning, good afternoon, and lovely evening to whoever is watching this show from. My name is Daphine Gakuba, and this is Elevate. To you who are wondering, Elevate is an initiative that started in 2017 by me with the purpose of initiating dream and potential in a girl child for a positive change. Today I've got an opportunity to interact with different women with different experiences and opinions on topic today. I'll let them introduce themselves.
Okay, my name is Ineza Pierin. I'm a student at Strathmore University in Nairobi. I'm pursuing Bachelor of Commerce. I'm in my fourth year.
Thank you. My name is Priska Omurego, and I work at the African Management Institute.
Okay. My name is Munyerangu Grace, a lecturer at the University of Rwanda in different fields, but I'm a teacher by qualification.
Thank you so much. I'm so delighted to have you here, and thank you so much for coming through today. Our topic today is self-esteem. For you are wondering, what is self-esteem? Do we need self-esteem as women? Is it important? And if yes, how does it contribute? We're going to know more about it. American Association University of Women announced that ladies lose their self-esteem on their way to adulthood. Let me start with Ineza. Ineza, what do you understand by self-esteem in your own words? How can you describe self-esteem?
Okay, to me per se, self-esteem will be defined as the way you feel about yourself, how you know, I will put it easier by saying that it's like walking down the road as if you own the road. Like, how much do you like yourself as a person, as a lady, as a woman in our society, in your relationships with others, where you work?
For me, I think self-esteem is more about, I mean, same as you say, how you feel about yourself and think about yourself in and out as a person. And I think people with good self-esteem tend to have like confidence, and self-esteem is more about generally how you feel about yourself in and out. Yeah.
Maybe I'll have to introduce something newer than what they've said. I take self-esteem to be the evaluation one makes about oneself. So the value you attach, the worth, how you feel, you know. So it is normally rated high or low. So self-esteem is about judgment, how you judge yourself in terms of value and worth.
Thank you so much. And we as ladies wonder, why do we need self-esteem in the first place? So to all girls out there watching, and you haven't even heard about self-esteem, what do you think a girl out there in the 21st century, why would a girl need self-esteem? Because before, it was necessary, but it wasn't that necessary as now. Because today people, we have social media, people want to be like others, people don't set what they should be. They want to collect from what they're saying to be someone. So what do you, why do we need self-esteem in this century?
Go ahead. All right. I think self-esteem is generally how, like I said, it's how you believe in yourself, how you take yourself. And I think it's so important because it affects your daily activities. It affects your daily life, how you live with others, your social life, your social choices, like everything you do. So I think if you have good self-esteem, it's gonna give you courage to make good decisions. It's gonna give you courage to be your own person. It's gonna make you believe in your values and principles of life, and you will feel confident saying no. Like you said, currently people wanna, like, you know, be like others. Yeah. They're influenced by other people's choices, and you get lost in that, you know, trap of like, I wanna be like that person. I think they're doing better than me. So you feel confident about saying no to all those noises outside and then be your own self. Yeah.
I will add on and say that self-esteem is necessary even this century, even where we are today, because people need to make decisions. People still make choices. And self-esteem affects our choice-making and decision-making. High self-esteem will help you to make good choices and therefore good decisions, while low self-esteem will do the opposite, will really wreck you down, you know. So it is very important that women, young girls, should have some level, some degree of a higher level of self-esteem to help them face the world today.
Okay, as my opinion is, as a woman, you have to have self-esteem to establish any relationship in life. As a woman, you have to have self-esteem. As she has said, you have to be assertive. You have to decide. You have to make clear decision in your life. And that depends on the level of the self-esteem that you have. So I would say, as Madam Grace has said, a healthy degree of self-esteem is better for you. Not too low, not too high. Because low self-esteem will lead to destructive relationships, and high self-esteem also can lead to destructive relationships. But a healthy degree, when you strike a balance, an accurate balance of your self-esteem, where you can make accurate decisions, you're able to establish good relationships with others and also with yourself, you're able to say yes to this, you're able to say no to that. Yeah, I think self-esteem is equally important, and healthy level of self-esteem.
Well, in addition to that, as girls, like Madame Grace said, self-esteem is important, because if I quote her, they say, you can literally know how to say no and yes. And it's being a very big issue out there in society. Girls don't even know the right time to say no or yes. We are afraid we're going to lose them if we say no or something. So, but when you have, if I know that this is a cup of juice, no one is going to tell me that it's a cup of tea. So if I know very well that that I have a healthy self-esteem, then no one is going to tell me I am unworthy, I am unwanted. All the opinions of other people are not going to be that bad if you have a healthy self-esteem. But what various ways would we improve our self-esteem? Because I'm sure there's so many girls out there who don't even have the right or the healthy self-esteem, and they're wondering what can I do, how can I do it to increase it or have a better one.
Okay, I would like to say there are different ways how you can improve your self-esteem or how you can change your self-esteem. Some of the various ways include by evaluating yourself. Okay, you opt to improve your self-esteem when your self-esteem is low. So that means that you have to evaluate yourself. Mm-hmm. You have to sit down and say, okay, I'm that person. When you have low self-esteem, you're that person who sits down and you perceive your negative abilities. You just look at what you cannot do, but you don't see what you can do. Put much effort on what you can do and realize that you have your flaws as a human being. It's okay as a woman to feel you cannot do that. It's okay. You're just a human being. It's okay. You cannot do everything. But what you can do, do it best. And have it in mind that there's someone out there who can appreciate you because you can do that. Because, mind you, you're the person who can do it in the best way possible. And another way that I can give is by... self-esteem is not something that is built overnight. It's not by reading a novel that you're going to improve your self-esteem. It's by practice that your self-esteem is going to be healthy. The other way that I was saying is by looking onto others. There are people in our lives that, for example, we might call them role models. We have our mothers, we have our aunts, we have our lecturers, we have our sisters, we have our friends, we have everyone in life. There's that person that you look up to, and when you want to aim higher, there's this person who has made it in life or probably has gotten to a certain level.
Yeah. Mm.
You'll be looking at them and be like, okay, I want to get there. And slowly by slowly, you believe in yourself, step by step, as time goes by, you make it, and it just gradually comes that you believe in yourself, and finally, you build your self-esteem.
Yeah, true. It is true. But I wanted to add one. When we talk of self-esteem, you said it is like, it is on a continuum. It is like a measure from 1, for instance, to 10. So maybe when we talk of health, we are talking of in between 5 or 6. That means each one of us will have elements of low self-esteem and elements of high self-esteem. So to improve on your self-esteem, you have first to check yourself, to look into yourself and find out where you are negative, where you are low, what's the element of your life that you judge to be, may I use the relative word, poor or negative. You think of those other areas where you judge yourself, where you criticize yourself unnecessarily, and then you start by changing. Say, oh, I think I will give example. I've dealt with girls, I've dealt with women as a woman, I'm a woman. And sometimes you feel maybe you don't look that, you don't look nice. But who is judging you? Who has told you that you don't look nice? Who has told you that you are ugly or what? It's your mind. So check your mind and see where there's negative, you turn it into positive. Some other way is like, you change. You change the peers, the people you are with, the group members, the people you move with. If they are pulled down people, the negative ones, those that tell you that you are not up to it, leave them. Go for the positive ones. Because in life we socialize, but we meet people who put us down. And there is a tendency of young ladies of going with them, say, okay, if I don't join them, then I'll feel bad or I will be judged less. Don't go join the group, join the peer group, join the friends that can really uplift you. As a girl, as a woman, as a lady, because we all have areas of change. So it is possible to change. And to improve.
Thank you so much. Priska, would you help us? What do you think influences our self-esteem as girls?
If we do it?
You lose.
What do you think influences our self-esteem as women out there?
Mm. I think that's quite a broad question, but I'll just speak as me as what I think. It could be anything. It could be society. It could be media. It could be your background, as like where you grew up from,
yes,
and anything around that. So I think I think it starts from as from you as a child.
Nabazaga mwe abana b'abakobwa nkamwe murabivuga mu cyongereza ariko nk'umwana w'umunyarwanda kazi yakubaje ati self esteem ni iki, wamusubiza iki? Nihagire utubwire icyo self esteem uvuze mu kinyarwanda.
I'm not really good with Rwanda, but I think kwitinyuka, kwimenya,
it's more kwitinyuka,
kwisobanukirwa
is the word. Kunago nibaza ko hari ijambo rimwe
ri mu Kinyarwanda. I don't know if there is a word that would go by kwitinyuka, or that would go with self-esteem, but as a mother, you would help us. I'm sure you're
Kinyarwanda nyine ubundi self-esteem nyine icyo twavugaga ni ukuvuga ngo uko wiyumva. Ayo manota urimo kwiha bigendanye n'agaciro kawe ni ayahe? Kuko ashobora kuba ari amanota maremare, niba ari ku ijana ukaba wiha 40 ngo turi buvuge ngo uritinya. Kuko kwitinyuka nta kurimo, urigaya, dukoresha ijambo kwigaya, urisuzuguye. Ni amagambo ari negative. Iyo byaramutse cya gipimo twavuze mbere wagiye nko munsi ya virenge hasi, urumva ko twakoresha ayo magambo mu gusobanura self-esteem. Self-esteem iyo izamutse zamura kwitinyuka, yagwa ikazana kwigaya.
So Katiri Kubuga, what are the various ways you would increase or improve your self-esteem? But I think usually when someone says self-esteem, what comes to my mind first is what goes with it is self-awareness, because there's no one who can have self-esteem with no self-awareness. And I think people should, in our society we have a lot of opinions. Everyone is going to give you her opinion about your life, in fact about your own life. This person is not going to be your mother or someone from outside.
Yeah.
No, when it comes to social media, you know the Instagram thing, you post a negative post, it's always gonna bomb and you put on it. So what you say to yourself or who you say you want to be is gonna help you go through all this. Because it's not always going to be good days. At the end of the day, as women, we face low days. You can't always have the best self-esteem. But as women out there, who actually even has it or have it, how can we improve it?
Self-awareness.
Yes.
Numva uhari abiganisha sinzi.
Yeah.
Sinzi ko twabona ikinyarwanda kibisobanuye dushobora kubyita kwimenya kandi kwimenya ni bibi. Kwisobanukirwa ni byiza. Ngira ngo ni byiza ukamenya intege nke zawe mukuri utibeshye. Ukamenya imbaraga zawe ni zihe ibyo ushoboye ni bihe. Ukabimenya noneho kandi ukabimenya wizi an objective of making good use of the strength and correcting your weaknesses. I think that's what self-awareness is all about.
Yes. Okay, I can add on to what Madam Grace has said. Before self-esteem, they come what you call self-awareness. You're not going to have the self-esteem even if you preach from morning till evening when you're not aware of yourself, when you don't understand yourself. She mentioned something about social media, and it's our 99.9% influence around us as women, as youth, as girls. So I think in collaboration with social media and self-awareness along with self-esteem, I think we should first understand the self-awareness. You understand yourself before someone says something bad to you, or before you go to Instagram and you want to live to Priska's standards, and my friend, you know you can't. You know you can't, but you're trying to live to her standards. You should be aware of yourself. Before you do that, the whole world is watching. Some people don't care. Some people are there to hurt you. Their aim is to hurt you.
All the way.
Calm down.
So by the time you do all that,
self-awareness, reka tubikore nk'uruziga nka sako. Hari agace k'iyo sako umuntu, wowe nk'umukobwa, wowe nk'umuntu wiyiziho. Hari akandi abandi bakuziho utiyiziho. Kuko abantu iyo dukora, iyo twakitinga, abantu baratumenya. Twe tukibaza ko turi ibitangaza ariko batubonye ukundi. Hariho n'utundi duce nakwita utw'impumyi cyangwa se blind spots. Utiyizi na bariya batazi, ari byo mu Cyongereza bajya bavuga potential. Hari ubwo tunanirwa kumenya our potentiality. Self-awareness rero ifata ibyo byose. Ese ibyo abandi bazi nanjye niyiziho ni ibihe? Bashobora kuvuga bati Grace umera gutya na gutya, nkemeranya nabo, ibyo mpakanya nabo ni ibihe, niyiziho bo batanziho, ibyo banziho njyewe ni ibihe. Iyo ushaka rero kwimprovinga, kwa kundi yatubajije ati umuntu yakora iki kugira ngo azamure self-esteem ye, ugerageza kumenya kwimenya, ukadiringa ndetse n'abantu ukababaza niba ufite inshuti cyane, niba ufite umuntu ugukunda akakubwiza ukuri uko akubona. Kuko umuntu uko akubona, uko abantu bakubona bamwe, ntiwabimenya kereka bakubwiye. Ariko iyo bakubwira hari ubwo rimwe na rimwe batubwiza ukuri kukatubabaza iyo ujya kubishaka kuko ushaka gukira ugenda witeguye no kubabara umuntu akakubwiza ukuri kuko agukunda kandi nawe ukabyemera haba hariho icyo ugomba kwimprovinga ukakimprovinga haba hariho icyo ugomba gushimangira none ugashimangira ukavuga uti I'm strong I can do this I can you know so self awareness ntabwo twayibagiza rwose in improving
self-esteem.
Yes.
Yeah. So to just add on to what Madam Grace just said, hari ibinavuze bijyanye na people's opinion, ikuna abantu babona, kuna bikubwira, there is in a positive way and in a negative way. Hari igihe rwose aba bantu badukunda batubwira ibintu ari ukuri, and okay, it hurts us if it's wrong, but there is also the negative. People are not always
negative.
Yes. Yeah. And it's actually highly influencing our choices.
Yes.
And our self-esteem. People's opinions, we have them on social media, people's opinions about you is one of the reasons why our self-esteem goes down. So to all girls who are watching out there, yes, people are going to have good and bad opinions about your life, but it's you to choose.
Yes.
As I said before, say it yours before. So if she gives you one, when you already know more about yourself, let it not influence you in a negative way, but always in a positive way. What do you say?
Yeah, that's true. Actually, we need to, I think it's probably we can call it Western, because if you tell someone so African about it, it will be out of topic or it will be a bit awkward. It's called minding your own business. There's this thing that you know about yourself.
Yeah.
My dear, no matter how much I tell you, Ineza, I don't know you can't walk as you're walking. I don't know your what as you're doing what.
Yeah.
I don't know you're dark as what. My friend, as long as I know the way I am,
okay,
I set my standards.
I think,
yeah, there's nothing to...
Ariko tugomba kuba careful because yeah. there are certain negative words. I'm sorry to mention them.
Yes.
What do you take deceit to be? Deceit.
Yeah.
Because you can deceive yourself that you are a certain way because you like it. Why actually you are not?
No, that comes in as a high self-esteem.
Very high one.
High self-esteem that might lead to, which is a mental disorder, by the way.
The right word Ineza is trying to say, I think, it is set goals.
If you set your goals,
okay.
Be confident standing
and
forward.
Be confident
yeah.
with it. Your opinions, okay, they are. I'm gonna count people's opinions. We can count them.
Yes.
But most of the times, it overtakes us. Concentrating. Oh, how you see me?
So how do you
see you?
How do you find a balance?
Yeah. And
you need to strike a balance,
okay.
Because
she's on track. She's right saying setting goals.
Yes. Yeah, I think that's the right word we are
yeah.
looking for.
When we set goals, we get focused. We have to focus on the goals we have set.
Yes.
Abandi tukabihorera ngira ngo nicyo ashatse kuvugamo minding your own business.
Which is so necessary
yes.
though. People
yeah, very,
learn how to mind their
business. Very,
yes. very, very necessary. By
yes.
the way, if we learn to mind our own business, because
it's gonna be amazing.
Yeah, it's gonna be easy. Let me tell you from life experience, no lie. I'm a don't care in life. Not that I don't care to that level. No. We talk we could
have.
Yes. The necessary one.
Bigufitia kamari.
Yes.
So like new munagohai a negative something about yourself, but you are very sure that that's not.
Do you know what I do? When you tell me something so bad about myself or my performance is so
maybe
bad.
It's true.
No, let me. Do you know what
but
I do?
Let me tell you, Prisca, when something is true and it's on you, most of
yeah,
the time,
you know.
99% you know.
You know.
Before
it.
You actually to come tell me. And the
okay,
worst part
okay,
is
okay,
how?
Let's read it.
Because she says
sometimes we know. But
some
because of where we came from, the self-esteem we have, and actually it is like because of self-esteem, we don't want to accept what we are.
Yeah. But
you aim higher, you want to be like this, you are told reality. No, that's why I said in the beginning,
we should consider it
first check.
Evaluate
yourself.
Yeah.
and do an objective evaluation. You know, evaluate
that's
yourself and say, actually, this is, you know, I cannot tell lies, girls, that I can do what you can do. But self-esteem is not about abilities.
Yes.
Yeah.
It is about how mental, you know, feel. So I don't feel bad if I can't dance, I have strokes like you would have, you guys.
Yeah.
I say, oh, she's okay, they are younger, mood. And I take it okay.
Yes, and I think, I think when you know something about yourself, you know, what hurts most is that it's not that kwabimbiye, but you actually, people who come to tell you the truth about yourself, is that most of the time they're also struggling with things they don't know. So the better way to do it,
it's the basic of life.
If I know the truth and I choose to overlook it, I don't really get why you should come to let me know while you're still struggling with your own thing.
Okay.
That's the minding your own business thing.
So it's necessary.
Okay, I think that one taken it really well.
Yes.
Yeah, minding someone whose business is okay.
Okay.
It is polite. It is impolite to go into other people's business when you are not invited anyway.
the proper word will be snooping. Snooping.
People come in different ways. If you come to tell me about it in a positive way, most of the times we are not angry. You know, you literally can't do that.
Yeah, that's right.
None of them my reasons why I can't. Oh, how I can even try.
Ignore.
She's just in jumping into conclusions.
Ignore.
You can't do that.
Ignore and go on. Achieve your goals.
Yes. So, as we said, self-esteem is necessary. But if it is, how has it contributed to our lives? To where we are today?
Oh,
Madam Grace, go fast.
I didn't know that this one would come.
Yeah.
But self-esteem, I gauged it when I was mature. That's when I learned to understand what self-esteem is. I used to have problems with being assertive. Somehow I was not so passive per se, but this word assertive, being able to say no when it is necessary and yes when it is necessary. I was helped, like we are talking now, we learned about self-esteem. Then I accepted. I went into this exercise of self-awareness. Yeah. I approached people and people gauged me. I found indirectly my self-esteem was low. And I realized the impact of low self-esteem. I used to fear people. I used to fear what other people were doing. I would look at, I was a teacher and a conservative teacher. One who would stick to, even now I have long things, but even short ones I can put them on. So I was made to understand my skirt should always be below the knee, I should behave in a certain way. Plus the society I was coming from, umukobwa agenewe kumera gutya, nibiri negative, nibiri iki. So urabajije uti byagufashije iki?
Gute byamfashije kugera ku byo wagezeho?
Ndashaka kubabwira ko byampaye akazi.
Wow, now my son, that's great.
Super great.
Yampaye akazi, ndangije my first degree, ndetse narahuye n'ibi bintu bya self-esteem. Nari ntarahura na interview in my life. Kuko mbere nari narabaye teacher wi Gakuba teacher wa graduating aga bakagupostinga into a certain school. There was no room for being interviewed by people.
Yes.
So I heard of job interview. I was like, how would it be? Abantu kugukoresha interview bakakubaza ibibazo babaza bibazo nge nyabaki. I ventured into it. Actually my results were not yet out. But I went for the interview. I got a chance. And all that was out of self-esteem, mine being stepped up. I believed I could go. They test me, they ask me my results, I tell them, Tamanotanda Abona, Haichi, Bakaziwakame Chango Wakanyu. Bajenda, Ndinjira, interview about Gamovafite, Doctora Ichi, Warambaza, ngiye kubona mbona bamwe baravuga icyongereza n'igifaransa, ngiye icyongereza cyanjye numvaga gifite urwego nkabasubiza neza. ako wambajije ikibazo kimwe ntekereza ko cyari gifitanye na isano na self esteem. Umwe interview arambajije bijyanye n'amanota, nababwiye kuko nagiye gukora interview ntarabona amanota, nararangije ibizame gusa ariko amanota ataraza. Barambaza ngo kusaba akazi amanota yawe ataraza ariko ya nyuma, like
the final results,
the last semester, kusaba akazi amanota ataraza niki cyatubwira kuzatsinda? Out of self esteem ndababwira ngo kuva ntaratsinzwe semester ya mbere sinsimbi ya kabiri umwaka umwe nkawurangiza wa kabiri nta kizambaza gutsinda ubu ngubu.
I need that
kind of comment.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Umuyobozi w'ikigo aravuga ati turashaka umuntu ufite confidence nkuri.
Yeah, definitely. So as girls, sometimes we do need this. You know, some of us actually have chances and opportunities, but we lose them because we don't have self-esteem. Because you think, I cannot do that. Why me, Daphine? Why would I sit on that table? You know? And we end up losing things because of this. And as you say that you learned how to say yes or no, I would literally stick on this. Girls of these days, including everyone here, because we all have weaknesses, this is why we are facing most of the issues. We don't know how to say. It's not like we don't know.
We don't set boundaries.
We don't set boundaries.
Yeah. Yes.
We are afraid we are going to lose these people. Mm. If I tell him no, he's gonna go.
We so but much real, want to adjust to reality.
Real people stay because they are meant to stay. You know? If he shrugs and he leaves, then he wasn't meant to stay. So people should understand that self-esteem is important, because I was a job offer, but as I started Elevate, I had so many people telling me different things. You know, you're young, you can't do this.
Yeah.
How are people gonna say it? How are you gonna go up there and say your story? But this is...
You believed in yourself.
I believed in myself. I was like,
you knew you could.
Knew I could. I was like, this is something I am not going to drop. Whether you like it or not.
I can.
I had confidence. Never know. Definitely your confidence. That's
to another level.
That one thing, I know I have one. So as ladies out there who are watching, go, women, or let's not even stick to women.
Everybody,
you need to wake up and go for that one thing you think you can do it. Let a friend not drag you down because of one opinion she has on you.
Okay, let me add
something.
Me add something. We are talking about self-awareness, self-confidence, self-worth, and self-respect, self-stuff. But I think, it's all about it. It starts somewhere. Mm-hmm. I think we have concentrated much on women and ladies, but to parents, to aunts who are watching this, please, this is your word. Teach your kids how to be them. Teach your children how to do A, B, C, D.
Yeah.
Because that's their home. That's where they learn everything. It's not like this is heavenly sent something, because you're not going to learn it from heaven. It's something that we have to learn from our mothers, from our fathers, from our aunts. It's you do not have to tell your kid, for example, as Daphine has said, I'm sorry to say, but it would be so bad of a parent saying such a thing. To put it in Kinyarwanda, it would be so harsh. That's not something to tell to your kids. Let them go on. Teach them how to be themselves. Let them have the freedom. Yeah. Not too much, but at least, because the world that we are living in today, it's not the ancient days where women, what women do and what men do.
Talk of it.
No.
I think that's a very imperative point. When it comes to parents, guardians, whoever like has a kid that they take care of, I think make it a safe environment for your kid to grow. Do not be hard on them when they mess up or when they fail. Failure, I think, it's a part of life. Not to say that you have to make it an option, but when you fail, I think you learn. It's not like you stay there, or that's like failure defines who you are.
Yeah.
You just need to like fail and then learn from the mistakes, and then, you know,
And most of the words that parents tell us, you do it to design.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
The words that they keep.
If it's coming from my mom, trust me. It's just coming from my mom. So, umwana gakura yumva ko it's my mom. We were expecting more from parents. The good thing, my parents are positive, but I have friends that are suffering from this thing.
Yeah.
So as a parent who is watching, please try encourage your kids. We are facing a lot as youth out here.
It comes from TV.
Social media is becoming a thing. Peer pressure is becoming a thing. So we are expecting more from you than telling us to go, we are really expecting a lot from parents.
It should be a safe environment.
Yeah.
Bakiriho kuko nko mu Rwanda ntabwo leta y'u Rwanda yakwemerera ko umubyeyi akubita umwana ko environment iba hashi ku mwana ariko physical
this
physical abuse
actually physical abuse is something physical can be healed and easily. But there's what you call emotional abuse that is going
and
on
that is
everywhere.
And it's
killing people. Yeah. And parents are complaining. They are getting depressed. They're suffering from anxiety.
Let me tell you, ABCD. African parents don't believe in depression. And that is
Do you think depression
is a thing? Yes. Depression is real. Ntabwo nabangeza ntarabona abana baba depressed, abanyeshuri baba depressed, nkabibona kandi wamukurikirana ukazumva iyo depression, anxiety, ibyo byose nibituruka kuri low self esteem. Ugasanga ibibazo byaturutse mu rugo. Urugo rudafite environment umwana yakuriramo neza. Niba badakubita umwana b'ubwabo bararwana. Abibona. Cyangwa se harimo ubusinzi izindi ngeso mbi zose
niba batanarwana umugabo arataha agatuka umugore cyangwa umugore agatuka umugabo
ibyo bituma abana bigunga ubwigunge ni nayo depression burya
agakabije
ukabona ni nabyo ikintu the trending thing nowadays parents are complaining my kid is a gay but look
where has it come from.
Your house.
No one, the drug addicts, the whole thing. It depression with
yeah.
You can't. It's one thing people should understand. Words can break you or build you.
True. And they do.
Words can either build you or break you.
That's
the way
true.
I grew up believing in that. Kandi it is becoming a big issue. Ntago byaye mu Rwanda cyangwa no muri Africa abenshi barasobanukirwa why depression if you can eat. Go to a good school, have whatever you're asking
for. I'm giving
you
everything you have. Yeah?
Why depression? But those words you tell a kid, cyangwa nibyo yumva handi.
Reka rero dutere intambwe, turebe uko umuntu yakira. Ababyeyi barahari, mu environment, hari n'ibindi bintu byatuma umuntu agira low self-esteem twabivuze. Na bullying ku ishuri, n'ingeso mbi inshuti zawe zifite. Noneho umuntu yakwikura muri ibyo bibazo gute kugira ngo abe umuntu muzima umwana muzima uzavamo umugabo muzima ngiye kugenda avuga abakobwa n'abahungu ntago njya mvangura kuko low self esteem ikubita bose nimurekereho tuganire twumve uko bimwe ibyo umuntu yakora umwana muto w'umusore urubyiruko inkumi bakora iki kugira ngo ejo habo habe heza hatazaba affected by low self esteem hari cyo mwaba mubifiteho mu bakobwa mu
as a mother she just and I
don't do high ariko that's true hari we are living in a modern world where everything is on our table everything we need is already set for us so hari a lot of things that you can do. For example, to build your self-esteem, you can focus more on your abilities. Something else, Also, it can start by your role models. Nanone, it can even start from your home. If your mother is negative, your dad is positive. Look at your father. Leave your mother's business. No, you have a life, my friend.
Yeah, sure.
And you know, thank you to them. They brought you on earth. But anyway, the afterlife is up to you. So you have to choose. Yeah, you have to choose.
Yes,
you have to choose who to look up to so that you have a healthy life. Healthy living does not mean sorry. Mm-hmm. Doesn't mean eating and sleeping. No.
Okay.
It's being emotionally stable.
Yes.
So as we
come,
definitely.
Holding
mirrors.
Yes.
So as we conclude, as we come to conclusion, if you have something to say before we conclude, that wasn't a part of the conversations we had, or an advice to women or whoever is watching, you can have a second.
Okay, personally, let me tell you, in life, please, there are two things that I'm going to talk about. Minding your own business.
Again.
This girl. No.
In bold. In italics, in caps, everything
highlighted.
Mind your own business.
In a positive way.
Please, in a positive way. The outer noises, those people who say you can't, those people say you look like this, those people, no, please.
Yeah, you're beautiful.
No, it's their life, it's their opinions. You have your life, you have your business. Manage it. Leave it and mind it.
Thank you so much, Ineza. Priska, do you think you have something to say?
Yeah, definitely. I think maybe two or three things. Accept yourself.
Yes.
Understand who you are and accept it. And then maybe you can adjust from that. Also, stop saying I can't. I can't is negative. Because like, you have accomplishments, no matter how small they could be. But there's something you have really done. So embrace that and then, you know, build from that. Yeah. Mm.
Ugurangye ngiye kubabwira from India ngo tutigeze tuvugaho ndakuzana Christian angle. Buriye yuko mutureba twese Imana yaturemye mu ishusho ryayo. Twese dusa n'Imana. Niba ari wowe musa cyane, niba ari nda, ariko twese we are created in God's image. Kandi twese umushumba wacu n'umwe n'Imana. Ntihagire umuntu rero waremwe n'Imana nayo yakuremye. Uguputinga down. Urashoboye, mukobwa urashoboye, mugore turebe urashoboye, mugabo turebe urashoboye, mwese murashoboye, bahungu murashoboye, kandi mushoboye gukora ibintu byiza cyane. Kuko Imana yabaremye ibafitiye imigambi myiza. Ahubwo nawe ibaza uti kuki ndi kuri iyi si, maze setting your objective. That life.
Thank you so much, ladies. I am so delighted. I was so delighted, and I'm still delighted to have you to be with me here. So I want to thank everyone who is watching, the beloved viewers. Thank you so much, and don't forget to subscribe. And I want to thank the technical team for making it happen. Thank you so
thank
much
you.
For the effort. And I want to ask each and every single lady or woman or whoever is actually out there to believe in you. Go out there and make it happen. Let no one hold you back.
Yes.
Thank you so much once again. This is Elevate Show. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.